We're in the finals, guys.
I feel like I'm a part of the top five. Like, I'm feeling the emotions on their behalf.
Yeah, I kind of agree. I didn't even know that the lockdown edition was going to, you know, make sense.
Yes, I thought it was going to be a backyard edition. You know, no new housemates, celebrities not getting into the house to greet them and all of those things. But it turned out to be the best one so far.
So if you were going to rate like the production from 0 to 10 of how everything went on the arena games, the house, the competitions, and the housemates, what will you rate them?
I'm going to give them a 10. A 10, because I just like everything about the show, the interior decor, the arrangements, the games. Everything was just so on point. Every time I'm watching the show, I'm always smiling like, oh, I love this.
Okay, for me, I think I'm going to rate it like maybe a 6.5, because a few things didn't really align. Like the arena games didn't make sense to me. That's what I think. Like most of the times, the arena games, is it that it was too difficult or it wasn't what it was supposed to be? And so that's one issue that I had with the arena games. Then the fact they didn't have ninjas, maybe because of the social distance.
Yes,
then
ninjas.
Yes, the crop of people that they brought together. I felt like, if not for Erica, that, you know, probably just caused a little bit of drama. The rest of them were just, they were just almost at par.
Yes, it's about that one. This year, everyone was just trying to scale through like Diane last season.
Yeah, so see now, they are all friends at the end of the day, so there was no much drama. So I feel like going forward, maybe they could look into getting different characters to, you know, cause more commotion in the house. But aside that, it was a good season, and they tried. Yeah, with the lockdown thing, they tried. They tried to be innovative. All right, let's quickly jump into the order in which they will be going.
V is gonna go first, then Neo might follow her.
The first person who will be going out will be Neo, for obvious reasons. He was trending this week for washing of pants and all of that. So I'm sure that a lot of people won't vote for him. After Neo, I feel like V is going to go next. Because to be honest, those two people, I think they were the luckiest people this season.
Absolutely. Nothing short of luck.
Yes, pure luck. How they sailed and they just coasted till the end of the show. They're really, really lucky. The one that would have annoyed me most, if it would have been Tricky T, if Tricky T stayed till the end.
Oh my God, that one would have been like,
I would have been so upset. But anyway, Neo and V making it to the last week, not bad at all. So Neo first, V second, then Dorothy will go afterwards, and then I know that Nengi Nengi will follow. She tried, and I feel like a lot of people sort of liked her, but I expected more from her in terms of like a lot of more drama
and stuff. She was just the Barbie doll in the house, just trying to look pretty on her own. Yeah, I mind herself in the mirror all the years. In fact, even not for all those clingy, I think we don't even have heard much about Nengi at all.
Very, very true, yes. Even not for all those clingy, there would have been nothing about her. Then, Leko definitely is winning. Like, that one, I'm just waiting to see the votes. It'll be so mad. Like, it'll be like a presidential election. The votes will be as it might. I'll be surprised if it doesn't hit 60-something%. Then Nengi will be like 21 or something. So I feel like that will be the order in which they will live.
From my own prediction, I think V will go first because V nags a lot. She whines a lot. She complains, she makes the biggest deal out of the tiniest issues in that house. I'm like, how is Neil still sane with this girl? Like, how is he still in his right senses? Like, this girl, you should have seen her yesterday night. You just whining about the same issue, and Lincoln just kept telling her the same thing, and she just kept, and she's always picking up a fight with Neil, whatever she's going first, in Jesus' name. Then Neil, obviously, Oluwa on guard, is good because they are just lucky. So two of them, V out, Neil out, then Dorothy, I think Nengi would go next, and of course, our fierce, if Lincoln doesn't win the show, Ebuka should not just sleep in Nigeria because that's not going to do with the organizers of the show. I mean, it's evident even to the blind that Lincoln
is. I don't feel like Lincoln has a competition.
I mean, everywhere you should see campaigns in Abeokuta, Lagos Island. There was even one woman that was getting a vote Lincoln and take free Amala. Can you imagine how insane that is?
Wow.
Yes, I mean. So it's evident even to the blind that Lekon is the winner of the show, but I just don't think that Lekon is ready for the alarming kind of love that is waiting for him outside the house, because I'm sure that he's not envisaging it to be this huge.
Yeah, that's the thing now. Usually you don't know what is waiting for your house.
But I'm sure someone like Nengi knows that she's going to be a big deal outside of the house. She has it in the back of her mind that, oh, people are going to love me outside of the house. Like, I'm going to be a big deal, I'm popping. But I'm sure for Lekon, seeing himself as a guy, you know, not like Nengi that has all the perfect body, beauty, and everything.
Yeah,
you know. So I feel like
I remember the first time I saw Lekon, I was like, how did they even
pick? Yes, I was like,
He grew on us,
absolutely. I was like, how did he get shortlisted to be in the house? But
yeah,
I mean, they probably saw beyond his looks and saw his smartness and intelligence, and that has helped him so far.
I feel like this lockdown season was specifically created for Lekon, because I just can't explain how someone just gets all this kind of love and attention from people. It's not like he did anything that spectacular. All right, so it's been an amazing season. Irish, it was great meeting you. Ire, it was great meeting you as well. And I believe that Zikoko has something coming up for us, and we'll be looking forward to that. Irish, any final words? Ire, any final words as well?
Thanks to all the guests that joined on the show. We liked your contributions, and thank you all for your comments on socials. We saw everything.
This has been an amazing ride. I'm super happy to have been on this journey. Like, I wouldn't trade it for anything. And we hope for more exciting seasons ahead.